I working on today? Lots of stuff out here. Well, this is the project right now. I'll show you what I got. This is a North Star branded 6.5 horsepower pressure washer. It's a true Honda Japan built engine. One of the good ones. And I've got the pump off of it right now because, well, the previous owner did not realize that if the cam is taken out, you better put it back in the right way or it ends up like that. Now the Honda, the timing mark on the crankshaft is real tiny. If there's any wear on that gear, it's even harder to see. So I have a correct cam here. I'll show you something. I've actually got an incorrect cam too. Let me grab it. Make sure you look up your exact part number, which is the rule anyway. So here's the cam that's broken and it interferes with the connecting rod if you don't time it right, and that's exactly what the previous owner did. He took it apart because he claimed it was leaking at the crankcase gasket or the crankcase cover gasket. Well, no, I don't believe that. This engine was never apart. This is Japanese built Honda, as I stated. They don't leak at that gasket unless somebody's had them apart. But when I see that drain plug, and the guy was very diligent about changing oil, if you look at that plug, it's all chewed up. He's had pliers or channel locks or something on it. Well, if that's not tight, it absolutely will leak. And then it oozes. So it looks like it's the crankcase gasket. It's not. It's that. I'll lay out that's what the problem was. But anyway, he takes it apart, gets a gasket for it, and in the process drops the camshaft out, puts it back in, doesn't realize he's got to time it. When he reassembles the thing, the first time he pulls the starter, that was the end of the camshaft. Of course, it's cast. And because you got the weight of the flywheel with all the inertia, when he pulled it, it spun around and snapped the cam right in half. So I ordered what I thought was the right cam. If you look at it right there, and you look at the correct cam, there's a difference in the I can't see where I'm pointing the camera, it's too bright. It's a difference in the casting right here. I'll hold it so the lobes are exactly the same. If you look closely, you can see the GX200 cam is actually cast a little smaller down the center. So I bought this one by mistake because I trusted somebody and I failed to look up my part number. Shame on me, so it cost me 20 bucks. Anyhow, I'm going to go ahead today and I've got fresh gaskets set for it. I will put the new camshaft in, reset the valves. I've already degreased everything because it was just loaded with oil. So that was the first project, is my pressure washer came out, which is sitting right there. And this got washed. So here it is apart. I'm going to talk loud because my neighbor is running the pressure washer cleaning something. Fortunately, there was no internal damage. But on a Honda, it's hard to see. Wait a minute, that's water. I can't find it. There it is. That timing mark is so hard to see, and if there's any wear on the end of this gear, it makes it even harder to see. So I've got paper towels and crap in there now because I have to wash it out. I also need to wash all the bolt holes out so the Loctite holds it. Everything is washed. The screw holes have been washed with carburetor cleaner as well. Everything's been blown out with compressed air, as has the cover. I also washed the camshaft. All the bolts have been washed of any grease. So we've got my assembly lube. I will smear up everything real nice. And then some blue, someplace, there it is, blue Loctite. I show you how you time one of these in case it didn't make sense the first time. You can see the dot on the camshaft. And then if you look very closely, let's see if I can get in on it. Little tiny dot on the gear, it's very easy to miss that. And of course, as you get wear on the end of that gear from age, it makes that even harder to see. So keep that in mind if you work on one of these. If you ever take the camshaft out and don't time it right, you'll end up with a camshaft that, like I showed you before, looks like this, what's left of it. They are quite expensive new if you buy a Honda part. I was lucky enough to find an original Honda used for 20 bucks with shipping. was not worn. The guy even threw in a set of tappets. So anyway, get it assembled, get it done. Don't forget the two little locators that usually fall out when you take the cover off. One there and there's one there. Don't be fooled. That hole, do not get anything. Just two involved, at least on a GX200. The valves have been adjusted, and on this particular engine, it's 6,000ths on the intake and 8,000ths on the exhaust, plus or minus 2,000ths. So as soon as I figure out where my envelope full of valve cover gaskets is, I will get it assembled. We'll get some oil in it. I'm very anxious to see if it starts. The guy I got it from said it was running before he took it apart, so I have not opened up the carburetor to see what, you know, presence I find down in the bowl. I figure I'll go for broke. I'll put gas in it and let's see what happens. If not, easy enough to pull the carburetor off and clean it. My neighbor is washing a small piece of plastic, or a little shelf unit, that he keeps in his yard. He asked to use a pressure washer since he saw I had it out. He has been at that, I kid you not, for the last 45 minutes. He even stopped long enough to go home and take a dump. He told me, I didn't really need to know that. And he's back at it again. I don't care, I think it's kind of comical. Of course, there's a video floating around of my neighbor on that side washing the pool ladder. That's before I knew how to edit, and there's four different videos he was washing it so long. All right, let's not make this a major project. I did find the valve cover gaskets. So let me clean this cover up because there's, of course, this piece of gasket stuck on it. The valves are adjusted. I will throw some oil in it, some gas. I hope I get some gas. I gotta figure out if I got any left. All right, we'll see. All complete, reassembled. I filled it with oil, put a little bit of gas in it, and I didn't record it, but for kicks I thought, let's drop the bowl off the carburetor and let's make sure there are no surprises in there. So I did that, dropped the sediment bowl out. There was no crap in that. Both were clean. Took the carburetor cleaner and gave it a shot up the main jet and the emulsion tube, just in case there was any residual crud. But I also gave it a couple of pumps of oil down the cylinder when I started it, before I started it the first time. So I have already started it. It did fire up on the first pull. I should have recorded it, but I didn't. And man, did it smoke because the oil I pumped into it. So let's see if it'll restart again without choke. Typical Honda, runs real nice. Except the idle speed is cranked way up on, I'll turn that down. But overall, very successful repair. It needs new rubber feet on the front of it. They're worn down, so it's walking all over the place. I have the feet, I just didn't bring them upstairs with me. All right, I'm very happy. Now the last test will be to shut off the gas valve, run the carburetor dry, and see if it holds. Because those gas valves will tend to leak when they get older. So you shut the thing off and then it weeps, and next thing you know, the bowl is full again. But other than that, very successful repair. So I've got the pump all degreased. I picked up a quart of correct oil for that. Guy claimed he changed it. I don't know what's in it. I'm just going to go ahead and dump it and refill it with proper pump oil for a Comet pump. I think it's 30 weight non-detergent, but don't quote me. I just buy a quart of their oil. It costs a little more, but you know you got the right oil. While I'm out here, let me go ahead and readjust that idle speed down to where it kind of belongs. Dremel tool will come out and I will grind the tab off of that. I now shut the fuel valve and I let it run the bowl dry. And we'll see if it stays dry. I'm at it. I'm going to go ahead and restring the starter. It's a little short. I don't know if someone... Nah, that looks like a factory knot. But the rope is not real long. So I'm not sure which size it is, but I got both of the common ones. But 5-minute job. Let's go ahead and do it. And then basically it's done. I put junk oil in it for the first few minutes because obviously it's, you know, it's been tampered with inside. So I'll run it for an hour or so on that oil and then go ahead and dump it and then put good quality small engine oil in it, which is what I normally use because it's got a higher zinc content than car oil. In case you didn't know that, you do now. But very successful repair. After I fix the starter, I'll go ahead and put the pump on it and connect it up to a hose and a gun and let's see if it makes pressure. Pump is supposed to be okay. That's what the guy told me. But that's the same guy that didn't know how to time it and busted the camshaft. So we'll see. All right, fresh rope in the starter. Now it's got plenty of length to it. Oops, maybe I got too much rope on there. I think I'll cut about 6 inches of that off because it's hanging when it tries to retract. I always put as much rope in as I can possibly fit and then wind the spring just tight enough to retract it so you're not, you know, overstretching the spring in the center. All right, let me fix that. Nothing's easy. The new 3/16 key is undersized. So if I take the original key and turn it a quarter turn, so I got fresh material on it, it fits nice and tight, or tighter. I thought a Honda crankshaft was 3/16. Apparently not, the key must be metric. I don't know. Shout out if anybody knows. That's what came out of it. Almost looks like two-cycle oil. I almost dumped that cup over too. So now I'll go ahead and put in the oil that Comet recommends for that stuff. Talk about timing. Look what just showed up. The mail carrier came by while I was putting the oil in the pump. I didn't bother recording it, but I will tell you that I put in too much and I had to siphon some of it back out. Got a sight glass on the side, but I couldn't tell with the clear oil when I was past the sight glass. Anyway, look what showed up. My 22 millimeter fitting that I need for the end of the pump. This had the other type of quick disconnect, and all the hoses I have for all my stuff is conventional 22 millimeter, easy for me to say. So I'll figure out where I left a roll of Teflon tape and I'll get that assembled. Yeah, I grabbed two wrenches, and of course I grabbed the wrong size. Why didn't one of you guys tell me it was 22 millimeter? It's brass, so you don't go too hog wild with it. All right, sounds good. The only Teflon tape I had handy was the yellow stuff, which is gas resistant, but that's fine, it'll do the job. All right, oh, I gotta get the rubber feet out of the basement. Let's get that done. Okay, finished, ready to do a test. I didn't have the right kind of rubber feet. These are worn completely down. Oops, looks like I can't pick it up. They were worn totally down. All I had was 3/4 inch and 7/8 feet. And it made the machine tip up in the air. So what I did, I cut a couple squares out of this nice heavy rubber. This is compacted ground up rubber. We actually used to use it at work to set satellite dishes on at the roof. It didn't deteriorate. And then, hang on, let me tip it back. I can go ahead and do that. And that's what I did. I cut a couple of feet, a couple square feet with the dot side down, and I sunk the bolt up inside enough so the bolt isn't contacting the ground. Now it's got a nice soft action to it. And except for the badly worn out wheel bearings on that side, which I will address later, certainly not critical. It's done. Let's hook some water up to it and see if that pump works. works just fine. I don't see any leaks, at least nothing to speak of. Last thing I will do is shut the fuel valve off, and then I just take the high pressure hose off, turn the water source back on, and let it run till the bowl runs dry on the carburetor. Pull it once or twice after that with the choke on. If it doesn't fire at all, then the bowl is dry and you can set the thing set, and the gas is not going to go foul. It's in there. July 3rd. Let's see what tomorrow's like. Weather's supposed to be decent. I have grass to cut at the other properties, so it's not like I'll be sitting partying. And the carburetor bowl is empty. And I put the choke on and pull it once or twice. At that point, you know, there's really no gas in the bottle. Yeah, a little bit. All right. And I like to pull engines till they get to compression when I store them. That way you know the valves are closed. All right, all set. Done, finished. The long and short of it, this machine was purchased on either Craigslist or Marketplace because it had a broken camshaft. The guy took it apart, former owner, because he said it was leaking at the crankcase gasket. This is a Japanese-built Honda engine, one of the true Japanese-built ones. They don't leak unless somebody's had them apart and messed with the gasket. So I knew what I was gonna find, and today I finally got out this defective plug. I saw the oil drain plug because the guy was religious about changing oil, and you can see how butchered it is. Apparently he didn't have a 10 millimeter socket. But what you don't see, well, threads look okay, right? Well, let me show you something. Here's a replacement. What do you see on there? See the washer, the aluminum crush washer? That's what seals. Well, the guy had left that off. I've got paper in here now because I had test oil in it after I did the repairs. I ran it a while. Now I've dumped the oil and I'll put good oil back in it. So that's the case. There was nothing more wrong than he lost the aluminum crush washer and tore the thing all apart in the process, broke the camshaft because he didn't time it right when he reassembled it. And the crankshaft came around, or the end of the connecting rod, and it snapped the camshaft in half. So anyway, for $100, I got a perfectly good pressure washer. I did have to buy a used camshaft, which I did. It's been reassembled, so I paid for a camshaft, a gasket, and I put a fresh spark plug in it, and at the same time, put proper oil in the pump, because I didn't know what was in there. Thing works flawlessly, and it doesn't have enough hours on it to be worn out. That's my project. I'm gonna put this proper plug back in, which, by the way, the blue socket does the trick. If you got a chrome one, it doesn't work as well. You got to have the blue one. The blue is great until you rub at it a bit, then all the blue coloring comes off. So, but they're Harbor Freight. I'm not complaining. All right, back to the project. Gus, 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 you realize that's the donut box you're sitting on again?